हे गाइस, यार डी बायोलॉजी में बहुत सारे साइंटिस्ट के नेम दिए गए हैं जो कि नीट के पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू से इंपॉर्टेंट भी है। हाउएवर, ये सारे के सारे साइंटिस्ट अलोंग विद द कंट्रीब्यूशन आपको एक जगह कहीं नहीं मिलेगा। सो आज के इस वीडियो का एम यही है कि मैं आपको थोड़ा सा टाइम बचाऊं और सारे के सारे साइंटिस्ट अलोंग विद द कंट्रीब्यूशन एक ही जगह आपको प्रोवाइड कर दूं। इस वीडियो को आप पीडीएफ फॉर्मेट में अगर डाउनलोड करना चाहते हैं तो डिस्क्रिप्शन में उसका लिंक मिल जाएगा। यू कैन गो एंड डाउनलोड द एंटायर लिस्ट ऑफ द साइंटिस्ट along with their contribution in PDF format and keep revising them as many times as you want. I would recommend you all कि at least एक बार तो ये वीडियो स्टार्टिंग से एंड तक जरूर देख ले, ताकि अगर आपको नहीं पता कि कौन कौन से साइंटिस्ट एनसीईआरटी बुक में दिए गए हैं तो एक बार तो आप लोग एटलीस्ट ये नाम सुन ले और थोड़ा फेमिलियराइज हो जाए, उसके बाद आप पीडीएफ फॉर्मेट से बार बार रिवाइज कर सकते हैं। सो विदाउट वेस्टिंग मच टाइम, नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद ऑल द साइंटिस्ट ऑफ एनसीईआरटी बुक। ये वीडियो बनाने के लिए ऑलमोस्ट पूरी एनसीईआरटी मैंने एक बार फिर पढ़ लिया आप लोग के लिए। So without wasting much time, let's get started. So पहले आपको मैं साइंटिस्ट का नेम बताऊंगा, उसके बाद उनका कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन क्या रहा है ये बताऊंगा। अर्नेस्ट मेयर, ही इज कॉल्ड द डार्विन ऑफ 20th सेंचुरी। सो कुछ साइंटिस्ट के नेम अलॉन्ग विद कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन हैज बी प्रोवाइडेड बिफोर एवरी यूनिट ऑफ क्लास 11 एंड क्लास 12 एनसीईआरटी बायोलॉजी, एंड आई हैव ट्राइड टू इंक्लूड दोज साइंटिस्ट एज वेल इन दिस लिस्ट। नेक्स्ट इज कैरोलस लीनियस, ही हैज गिवन द बाइनोमियल नॉमेनक्लेचर। His book by the name of Systema Naturae has been asked multiple times and he also gave the artificial classification system. George Bentham and Joseph Dalton Hooker, they gave the natural classification system. Aristotle, earliest attempt of classification was made by Aristotle. Huxley, Neo-Systematics, R.H. Whittaker, Five Kingdom Classification, Dmitry Ivanovsky. Name virus was given by him and virus meant venom or poisonous fluid. M.W. Bejarinek, he demonstrated that extract of an infected plant of tobacco could cause infection in healthy plants and called this fluid, the extract from the infected plant, as Contagium Vivum Fluidum, infectious living fluid. W.M. Stanley showed that viruses could be crystallized and these crystals largely consist of proteins. T.O. Diner discovered viroids. G.N. Ramachandran, analysis of allowed conformation of proteins through the use of Ramachandran plot. Anton von Leeuwenhoek first saw and described a live cell. Mark my words, live cells. Brown discovered nucleus. Matthias Schleiden, German botanist, observed that all the plants are composed of different kinds of cells which form the tissue of the plants. Theodor Schwann, British zoologist, reported that cells had a thin outer layer which is today known as plasma membrane. Schleiden and Schwann, they gave the cell theory. Rudolf Virchow, cells divide and new cells are formed from pre-existing cell. Omnis cellula e cellulae, this theory was given by Rudolf Virchow. Robert Hooke, the first person to observe or see a cell was Robert Hooke. However, what he saw was a dead cell. So if a question asks who was the scientist who first saw a cell, he was Robert Hooke. Who was the person who first saw the live cell? We have already covered that. Singer and Nicholson gave the fluid mosaic model. George Palade discovered ribosomes. Fleming, material of nucleus stained by basic dye, was given the name chromatin by Fleming. Melvin Kelvin. Kelvin proposed that the plants change the light energy to chemical energy by transferring an electron in an organized array of pigment molecules and other substances. Everyone knows about the Kelvin cycle. This is the man, Melvin Kelvin. He also received a Nobel Prize for mapping the entire pathway of carbon assimilation in photosynthesis. Julius von Sachs, he was a German botanist and he demonstrated that plants could be grown to maturity in a defined nutrient solution in complete absence of soil, what is now known as hydroponics. So Julius von Sachs was the person who first demonstrated the technique of hydroponics. Joseph Priestley, he discovered oxygen and revealed the essential role of air in growth of green plants. Jan Ingenhouse, sunlight is essential to the plant process that somehow purifies the air fouled by the burning candle and breathing animals. Julius von Sachs provided evidence of production of glucose when the plant grows. So all these statements that I'm reading out in contribution, these are the exact statements that have been given in NCERT. So agar aapko lag raha hai ki NCERT mein scientist kahan pe diya hai, mereko mil nahi raha, just try to remember the contribution part that I'm showing you over here. Pura NCERT aapka revise ho jayega. T.W. Engelmann used cladophora. This question has been asked, which of the following organism was used by T.W. Engelmann in his experiment. So he used cladophora, and what did he show? He showed that cladophora accumulated mainly in the region of blue and red light of a split spectrum. Cornelius van Niel, he used purple green bacteria and demonstrated that photosynthesis is essentially a light dependent reaction in which hydrogen from a suitable oxidizable compound reduces carbon dioxide to carbohydrate. So basically all these are from plant physiology photosynthesis chapter, and the entire sequence of the scientist shows how the scientists work out. And today we know what photosynthesis actually is and how plant uses different thing to convert sunlight into a light energy into a chemical energy. So all these scientists contributed for our understanding that we have of photosynthesis today. Gustav Emmerdam, Otto Meyerhoff and J. Parnas. EMP pathway or glycolysis was their contribution. EMP stands for, E stands for Emmerdam, M for Meyerhoff and P stands for Parnas. Charles Darwin and Francis Darwin, they observed that coleoptile of a canary grass responded to unilateral illumination by growing towards the light source, that is phototropism. So these were the man who first identified and demonstrated phototropism. F.W. Wendt, he isolated auxin for the first time. F. Skug, internodal segment of tobacco stem that contains the callus, proliferated only if, in addition to auxin, which had already been discovered, the nutrient media also was supplemented by one of the following: extracts of vascular tissue, yeast extract or coconut milk or DNA. So at that time when F. Skog carried out his investigation on tobacco plant, only auxins had been isolated and people knew only about auxin. So he demonstrated that along with auxin, there was some other material also necessary for the differentiation and growth of the tobacco stem. Miller identified and crystallized the cytokinins promoting active substance that they termed as kinetin. H.H. Cousins confirmed the release of volatile substance from ripened oranges that hastened the ripening of stored unripened banana. Panchanan Maheshwari, he worked on embryological aspects and popularized the use of embryological characters in taxonomy. He also contributed in the first textbook of biology for higher secondary schools published by NCERT. So the NCERT book that you are reading right now, the first NCERT book was contributed by this man. James Watson and Francis Crick, everyone knows about these two people. They proposed the double helical structure of DNA and the replication scheme for the same. Gregor Mendel, father of genetics, laws of inheritance. Mischa, discovery of nuclein. Frederick Griffith, transforming principle was discovered by this man. Oswald Avery, Colin McLeod and Macklin McCarty, they worked to determine the biochemical nature of the transforming principle that was discovered by Frederick Griffith. Alfred Hershey and Martha Chase, they gave the unequivocal proof that DNA is the genetic material. All the experiments that were conducted by these people are also important, which has been given in NCERT in detail. Matthew Michelson and Franklin Stahl gave the experimental proof of the semi-conservative nature of the DNA replication. Again, the experiment conducted by Matthew Michelson and Franklin Stahl is also important. T.H. Morgan, experimental verification of the chromosomal theory of inheritance. D. Vries, Correns and von Teschemark, they rediscovered Mendel's work. Walter Stewton and Theodore Boveri gave the chromosomal theory of inheritance. Alfred Stuart Wendt worked for mapping of chromosomes. Henking, he discovered X body in relation to how the sex of a baby is determined. You can read that out in NCERT. Taylor, यूज्ड रेडियोएक्टिव थाइमिडीन टू डेमोन्स्ट्रेट सेमी कंजर्वेटिव रेप्लिकेशन. क्वेश्चन हैज बीन आस्क्ड अबाउट दिस. विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग बेसिस वर यूज्ड इन अ रेडियोएक्टिव फॉर्म बाय टेलर टू डेमोन्स्ट्रेट सेमी कंजर्वेटिव रेप्लिकेशन ऑफ डीएनए. सो रिमेंबर इट वॉज थाइमिडीन. Francois Jacob and Jacques Monod, they gave transcriptionally regulated system, that is the lac operon. George Gamow, coat should constitute of a combination of bases. He suggested that in order to code for all 20 amino acids, the coat should at least be made of 3 nucleotides. So that the genetic code has to be a triplet. That was given by George Gamow. Hargovind Khurana, he gave the chemical method for synthesizing RNA molecule with defined combination of bases. Marshall Nirenberg, cell-free system of protein synthesis was given by him. Alec Jaffray developed the technique of DNA fingerprinting, an important one. Frederick Sanger, principle of automated DNA sequencing, developing method for determination of amino acid sequence in protein. So he has two contributions, Frederick Sanger, principle of automated DNA sequencing, and he also helped in development of determination, a method of determination of amino acid sequences in protein. Alec Jaffray, Frederick Sanger, very important. M.S. Swaminathan, he gave the concept of crop cafeteria, and he is the initiator of lab to land program. William Harvey, he discovered blood circulation. Louis Pasteur, by careful experimentation, he demonstrated that life comes from only pre-existing life. Oprane and Haldane, they demonstrated that life could come from pre-existing non-living organic molecules. S.L. Miller, he is known for his experiment. Experimentally, he demonstrated the chemical theory of evolution of life. Ernest Haeckel, embryological support of evolution was given by him. Carl Ernest von Baer, he disapproved the theory of Haeckel, which is proposed above by Ernest Haeckel. Alexander Fleming, he discovered antibiotic penicillin. Ernest Chain and Howard Florey, penicillin to full potential as an effective antibiotic was established by these two men. Lamarck, he gave the theory of use and disuse of organs. Langdon Down, Down's syndrome. Stanley Cohen and Herbert Boyer constructed the first recombinant DNA by linking a gene encoding antibiotic resistance with a native plasmid of Salmonella typhi murium. Again, an important organism, Salmonella typhi murium, was used by Stanley Cohen and Herbert Boyer. Alexander von Humboldt, species-area relationship was given by him. A graph has been given in NCERT regarding species-area relationship, an important one. Edward Wilson popularized the term biodiversity. Note over here, he just popularized the term biodiversity. It was not coined by him. David Tillman, plots with more species showed less air-to-air variation in total biomass. It was an experiment of Tillman where he considered different plots. You can read about that in NCERT. Paul Ehrlich, he gave the Rivet-Popper hypothesis. Again, an important explanation of why conservation of species is important by us. Robert May, he estimated that the global species diversity is at about 7 million. So that was the extensive list of all the scientists that have been given in NCERT book along with their contribution. I have tried my best not to miss on any of the scientists of class 11th or class 12th NCERT biology. These scientists are very, very important. Many a times in NEET exam, questions have been asked about these scientists, their contribution, different experiments they have conducted, or the experimental material that these scientists have used. So download this entire video in PDF format. You will get the entire list in PDF format. The link is given in the description. Go to that link, download the PDF format, and keep revising these scientists and their contribution as many times as possible. And don't forget to share this video with other NEET aspirants as well, because no one will compile all the scientists and contribution in single video or in single list and provide to you, which I have done over here. So don't forget to share this video with other NEET aspirants as well. So that would be all for this video, guys. I'll see you guys again in my next video. Till then, all the best and keep working hard. Do like and share this video if you find it helpful. And if you're new out there and you have not yet subscribed to this channel, go and subscribe it right now. You'll get a lot many useful things about NEET, about preparation of NEET. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.